how we can have faith in God's work, in His control, and His love. Then I have these few verses that I just quoted you. Psalm 24:1, the earth is the Lord's and everything in it. So everything belongs to the Lord. So I don't have to be afraid. Everything is in His hand. And then John 19:11, that Jesus said to Pontius Pilate, "You would have no power over me if it were not given to you from above." So everything that happens on this earth is with the permission of God. But it doesn't mean God caused it to happen to you. Remember, it's very different. Since Adam and Eve sinned, God has said, when you work on a field, the field will give you thorns and thistles. Since Adam and sin and Eve sinned, then there is problems in the world, always problems in the world. God did not cause these problems. It's sin that separates us from God that caused the problem. But God has everything in control. When you follow Him, He will provide for you so that you can overcome the problems. Okay? And then, the next point is Colossians 1:16 that I just told you, that everything was created by Christ and for Christ. So we were created by Christ and for Christ. So if you were created for God, for Christ, then you have a special, you have a protection by God. And you follow His plan, wonderful things will happen to you. For instance, I use an illustration. My cell phone. When I take care of my cell phone, when I take care of my cell phone, when I just throw it around, no, because it belongs to me. Something belongs to me, I'll take care of, right? Everything you have, you will take care of it. And we belong to God, like you're here now with God. If God is going to use you, He's going to protect you and help you. And your plan is in Him. Now, if this cell phone says, "I'm not going to make it possible for you to make phone calls. I'm going to help someone else, not you." Then you say, "You cell phone, you don't disobey me. What can, you know, you are no use to me." So if we say, "God, I don't want to follow your plan," then we become no use in the kingdom of God, and then we'll waste our life and we'll give in to Satan. But if we say, "Lord, I want to follow your plan," He will make sure to bless you. So these few verses are very important. And then Matthew 6:33, you all know that. "Seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be given to you." That because what I said just now, first, that everything belongs to the world, to God, the world belongs to God. And then secondly, without God's permission, nothing will happen without His permission. So everything happens according to His permission. That means everything is in His control. And then number three, we are all created by God for Him. And then four, you seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all this will be given to you. That means because God is in control, because nothing bad is going to happen without God's permission, everything, when you follow God, will come to you to bless you. So when we seek first the kingdom of God, all these things will be given to us. So these are verses from God's perspective that He'll make sure to bless you when you follow Him. And Psalm 34:10, another verse. Psalm 34:10, "The lions may grow weak and hungry, but those who seek the Lord lack no good thing." So even lions will get hungry or weak, but then those who seek the Lord will lack no good things because the Lord will provide for us. So when we see that, if looking at the world, everything in the world, from God's perspective, then we don't have worry. For instance, some people say, "Oh, I'm afraid, will I have a husband? Will I have a wife?" Some people are afraid, but let me tell you, God has it all planned in heaven. If that person is planned for you in heaven, He will not run away. If the person runs away, that's not the one planned for you. Now, but I have to tell you, God has planned some people to be married, some to be single, but it's okay. God planned Paul to be single, it's okay. There are many people in the church are single. And Paul said it's okay, because when you are single, actually you can serve God more. You can concentrate in serving God. So you don't have to be afraid. But if there's one plan for you in heaven, that person is not going to run away. You just go naturally, you follow God, you come across the person, and that person will be moved by God, and you'll be moved by God to be together. Just like my wife. Let me tell you, after my first wife passed away, I thought I would stay single and go into mission field and go to one place to another. But I found that this is not God's will. Actually, let me tell you, I did not chase after her and she did not chase after me. It just happened because God planned it in eternity. And I found that she is really the perfect mate. She's so loving to me, and she's so good and kind and wise and gentle. And one example, if there's something I want to do and she prefer that I don't do that, she will say her opinion, but she will say afterwards, it's still up to you to decide. That's how gentle she is and submissive she is, that she will say it's up to you to decide. I'll tell you my thinking, my perspective. I'd like you to do the other thing, but if you still want to do that thing, you do it. You make up your mind. So she's very gentle, and I thank God for that. And God has her plan for me in eternity. She's not going to run away. So I hope you won't be afraid. Even if you're single, you will not die from it. You will not have pain because of that if you follow God's will. But then if people always say, oh, I want a husband, I want a wife. If you want, then actually many things you want. Since childhood, babies, you know, little child, I want that, I want you to buy that for me, oh, I want that. And from childhood, we always want things. And then when we grow up, and then you will say to the husband, I want you to do that, I want you not to do that. And then we say to the wife, it's always, I want, I want. And we find that there's a lot of disappointment, because this is the way of people. It's not the way of the Lord. But you say, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Your will is the best. Now some people, you know, the Bible says in Romans 12:1, it says the pleasing will of God. The good, perfect, and pleasing will of God. Pleasing to whom? Pleasing to God and to us. You know, some people say, no, it might be pleasing to God, but it might not be pleasing to me. And some people think, well, the spouse God has planned for me, well, it's not the kind I want. I want the kind that really give me fun. You know, God, there's no fun. It's just, you know, it's always preaching, worshiping God. Some people think like that. But let me tell you, God's plan is the best. One person said to me one time, I dare not pray to God to ask for His will. Because she said, I'm afraid if God called me to Africa, then I'll be stuck. I'll be afraid. So she dare not ask for God's plan. So I said to her, your perspective of God is that God is so mean to you, that God plans the worst thing for you that you don't want. That she has a perspective that God is someone who always gives you unpleasant things. I hope we don't think like that. God always could give good things. So I'm happy to follow the perfect plan, the pleasing plan of God. When you follow God's plan, everything will turn beautiful. Let me tell you, my ministry is like heaven, because when I serve God, when I preach, when I lead worship, I'm like in heaven. When I'm with my wife, I'm like in heaven. When I have fun with my wife, I'm in heaven. When I'm counseling people, I'm like in heaven. Today I counseled 4 people this afternoon. I didn't expect to counsel so many people. But when they left, they were all happy. Aren't you happy? Some of you talk to me. And after they finished, they were happy. I enjoy the counseling. So I'm saying, God's will is good, perfect, and pleasing. So when we follow God's plan, that's the best that can happen to us. That's the most wonderful thing So I hope you believe that. Anytime we stay away from God's plan, that's where you will start to suffer. When you go away from God's plan, your life will start to suffer. You will start to have suffering. But you follow God's plan, the closer you are to God's plan, the more you will enjoy life. Now, this is my introduction to encourage you not to look at things from people's perspective. From people's perspective, it's like this. Like, this is a difficulty in front of you, and you look at it. Oh, it's so hard. Hard to get over it. But from God's perspective, you say, no problem. I'll fly over it. Let me ask you, is it easy to walk across a desert? Is it easy? No. Is it easy to fly over a desert? Very easy, right? From God's perspective, you fly over it, no problem. So when people look at life, the difficulties in life, then they are burdened. And that's why many people's prayer, let me tell you, some people's prayer are self-pity prayer. Let me demonstrate this. I heard people pray like this. Oh God, I'm in so much pain. Please have mercy on me. I need you. Oh, I'm suffering so much. Please don't forget me. Oh, please come and bring revival. Our church needs revival, but we don't have a revival. Oh, come. It's always saying, Lord, we don't have it. We don't have it. The way I pray will be like this. Lord, I know you have a wonderful plan in my life. No problem. Any problem, you have a wonderful plan to solve it. You have a way to solve it. And a revival, you are really happy to give it to us today when we submit to you. When we submit to you, the revival will start today in our hearts. So I have confidence. Revival will come when we all submit to God and have a close relationship with God and obey God. Then His revival will come, even tonight. If you all change and be full of the joy of the Lord and full of the strength of the Lord, and you start to bless people, revival will come to this church. If like this, you'll be able to bring people to Christ every week, every month. Like today, you know, this few days, I went to bless different people. They were all blessed. And I want to say, it's not me. It's God and you too. So I hope you have this understanding. With God, everything is perfect. Do you believe that?
Amen.
But sometimes we still have this resistance. No, God did not help me. God is too slow. God forgot me. God doesn't like me. Now, this is all lies. These are all lies because God doesn't mind that you have sinned. So long as you repent and ask God to forgive you. Because everyone says, I have sinned, Lord. I am not worthy of it. But let me tell you, God is happy to forgive you when you confess your sin. Even when David committed adultery and murder, he confessed his sin, and then when God saw that he was sincerely repentant, God forgave him and blessed him with Solomon. So God is not despising you. So long as you repent and trust in Jesus, He will bless you. Your whole life, everyone here will become superman or superwoman. In a way, I'm not boasting. I'm like a superman. Don't I? Everyone I touch seems to change. I'm saying everyone can be like that. I'm not saying I am like that because I've got behind me. It's not me. It's God. You can all become superman and superwoman. If you are all superman and superwoman, this church will grow crazy. When you rebuild this church, you say this church is too small. You have to make it bigger. Right? So if you really have this love and have the power of God, so this all this start with our perspective when we look at the Bible, when we read the Bible, when we pray, and when we lead worship. Instead of saying, Lord, help us, Lord. Now we can say that, it's no problem, but people keep saying, Lord, please help me, I'm in trouble, or saying, Now, if we say, let us worship, just saying that has not much power. But if we say it like this, Almighty God is happy to see us worship Him. When we worship Him, His blessings will flow to us. So from God's perspective, to describe worship is very different. You understand?
Yes.
Sometimes when we leave worship, we just say, let's worship. Sometimes when people hear that, it becomes empty words. But if we say like, God is right here. He's looking at us. He's very happy with us. So when we worship Him, He's very happy. And blessings will keep pouring down. Hallelujah. And the blessings will keep coming. And our life will be changed. That way, people will be changed easier. And also, we want to make Christian words more real. What do you mean? What do I mean? Worship. You make it a different way. Then you say, we can love God. God, you're so wonderful. I adore you. I admire you. I like you. Use words that people can understand better. I like you. You are such a wonderful God. I like you to be my God. I like you to be worshipped. I like to come to you and praise you and thank you. So use different ways to describe it instead of just saying worship. Or exalt your name. We use different ways to describe it. Oh Lord, your name is high above every name because by your name, wonderful things will happen. Therefore, when we think of your name, Jehovah or Jesus, we love that name. We like that name. We want to tell people about that name. Now this will become more real, right? We like to tell people about that name. We like to mention that name. When we hear the name of Jesus, we are happy. So these are ways that we can make biblical terms more real to people. So I'm going to lead praise and worship again. And then notice my prayer. I'm not saying I'm the one, only one doing that. Jesus is doing that. I'm just learning from God, from Jesus. I'm not saying I'm any special. I'm saying, when I say, you know, learn what I'm doing, I'm just saying, it's God who downloaded this to me. He sent this to me. And I hope you will pick this up to always look at things from God's perspective. And then yesterday I said that in the praise and worship, first we can declare the praise of God. Oh, God is right here. God is blessing us. God is wonderful. God is thinking about us and blessing us. So the prayer of praise, you have to write this down if you have not written it down. God is His prayer of praise. And then also in the praise and worship, we need to give instruction. Let us open our heart. Let us believe that God is right here to bless us. Let us trust in Jesus and have confidence and be free. And then number three, we have responses. Worship God, love God, we adore you, we like you. So you put those three together. Can you remember? Say it together, prayer of grace. Instruction. And then praise and worship. Praise and worship. So in the praise and worship, you can say these three kind of things. Instead of just singing, sometimes you just say and just say, people can feel empty if it's just singing. Sometimes people keep singing but without thinking about God. So we need to guide people to think more about God, to think of how wonderful God is. And also in prayer, say more about God's nature, God's love, God's care, God's protection, God's power, and then our response to Him. So you write this down. So say more about God's nature, His love, His care, His protection, and then our response. So when we pray for the church, we say, oh Lord, you have a wonderful plan for this church. You plan that this church will become a great church to bless many people. You want to bless this church. Lord, help us to follow your perfect plan. When we submit to you, when we obey you, then this church will become greater and greater. So I really encourage you to say more about the grace of God, the power of God, the love of God, the mercy of God, and also His commandment too is fine. It's good that God has told us to love Him and to obey Him, that you can say God's words, His grace and His commandment. Okay? So in this time, I hope you will really enjoy yourself and relax yourself and enter the presence of God. And when I lead you, please pay attention to what I do. And I hope the worship team tomorrow will start to use this method. Today, Kenneth told me, so many people said it's so wonderful. And I hope you will start to use this method. Hallelujah. So with the pianist squad, Here. Oh, please rise.
Hallelujah.
Oh. Do you know this song? I sing praises. You can stop it now. I sing praises. You're right here now. Hallelujah. And also be free. One thing is be free. Be very free. We are like angels in heaven. Angels are very free, very relaxed. So we can relax ourselves. Lord, we can come to enjoy you. We come to adore you. We come to enjoy your presence. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord Jesus, we want to come into your presence. You are right here with us. Help us to open our heart to you and say, Lord, I need you. I need you, Lord. Hallelujah. You're so happy that we come to you. You're so happy that we come to you. Oh, yeah, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Oh, yes, yes. But think of Jesus is here. Yeah, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Oh Lord Jesus, you are loving us so we can relax in you. We can relax in you. We can trust in you. We can enjoy you. And we can praise you. Oh, Jesus loves me. Hallelujah. Yes, Jesus loves you. Yes, Jesus, we need you. Yes, Jesus loves me. Hallelujah. So wonderful to come to you. It's so wonderful to come to you. Now these are responses. Responses. We can respond to God with emotions, feelings. Oh, it's so wonderful to come to you in your presence, Lord. Your peace will come to us. Oh, Lord Jesus, it's beautiful to be in your house, to be praising you and loving you, and to be loved by you. And to be loved by you. Oh, Jesus, Lord, help us, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, G. Oh, I sing praises to your name. Oh, Lord, praises to your name. Oh, Lord, for your name. Your name is great, and
Hallelujah.
forward and lead. Have you noticed what I did in the process? Actually, I noticed some people are very into it, but some people maybe you're not used to it. Maybe you have burdens and worries. Then you can be just, and something need to learn just to enjoy God. Oh. Can you do this? Now, let's stand up again. Enjoy God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Now try again. Stand up. Oh, thank you, God. You are so good. You are so good. You are so good. Think about the good things of God. If you have been thinking about the good things of God, then you can get into this easily. But in your hearts you have many burdens and worries, that is very hard. But if you think about God's grace and mercy and how He has saved us, how He has blessed us, then it's easy for you to experience it. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father. Praise you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let me ask you, have you noticed, you can sit down now, have you noticed what I did? How I enjoy God and I lead people to do it, and how I talk about the grace of God? And actually, tonight I'd like to encourage you to practice the prayer of grace, the prayer of confidence. Like this, you know, leading worship. Prayer like this. Describing God, oh Lord, you care about us, you know our needs, you want to bless us, you're so wonderful, you think about each one of us all the time, so we can come to you with confidence, we can come to you and trust in you and enjoy you and worship you, and you bless us. Now, let's try to do this. Everyone, can you come out and say something like this? What if you come out and say, oh God, you're so loving, and sing with feelings. God, you're so loving, you're so kind, you're always blessing me. You think about me, and you want to do great things in my life. Lord, I come to you. Now when you talk like this, can you think of God's grace more? Let me ask you, when I lead the prayer like this, is it easier to think of God's grace? When I say, Lord, you're so wonderful. You're right here. You're blessing us. You're with us now. You have a wonderful plan in our life. So we can come to you in confidence. We can trust in you and worship you and adore you. So describe the nature of God. Describe the wonderful grace of God. Now, does anyone want to come out and do that? Actually, each one can just take 1 minute. And try to describe God and try to say how wonderful God is. And then I will fill in with you. How to say, how to pray to touch people's heart. Instead of just saying, let's worship. Let's adore Him. Let's lift up His name. If we just say this, sometimes people cannot think of God and then cannot think of how to praise God. But when we say, God is very happy that we come to Him. So let us come to Him and say, Lord, I love you. Because God is very happy to see us here today. So describe first, God first, and then lead the people to respond to God. Does anyone want to try? Everyone can try, actually. Everyone can come out and pray for a minute.